Track 5, Modulating, contains the human LFO device, which is a modulator that can control any parameter with a humanized sine wave. Right now, one cycle is about 8.5 seconds, and every half cycle, the modulation amount is randomized by a percentage within a range we can specify with a humanized dial. The device is currently mapped to the filter cutoff of the instrument rack, but if we click map, the button starts to blink and we can map it to a different parameter. Rather than focusing on how the waveform is humanized, we'll take a look at how the map button is implemented inside the map subpatcher. The live.path, live.object, and live.observer objects allow us to communicate with Live's API. This will be discussed more in depth later in this pack, but in this part of the patch, we tell the live.observer object to monitor the live set and report ID numbers of whichever parameter we select. We can see the ID by adding a message box and connecting the live.observer's left outlet to the right inlet of the message box. For example, the ID of this volume fader is 473, and for this dial, it's 406. Note that these IDs can be different after you load a live set, so we can't store them. We need to query them every time. Whenever we click the map button, a bang is sent to the toggle, which in turn alternates between outputting 1 and 0 with every received bang. Inside the blink subpatcher, a 1 switches on a QMetro object, which outputs a bang, which makes another toggle object alternate between outputting 1 and 0. Depending on when it's a 1 or a 0, different colors are then set for two color attributes of the map button downstream. Note how we use color names instead of color values. The colors specified by these color names change when you change the live color theme. In the helpatcher of the live.colors object, on the All tab, we can see all the color names and their corresponding default colors. To see the colors as they appear in the current live theme, copy this bit of patch code and paste it into a Max for Live device. For now, let's copy one color name and paste it in the message box. The color messages are then sent downstream, out of the second outlet, which then loops back around to the map button. Whenever we click the map button, we not only turn on the blinking, we also open a gate so that the ID of the parameter we select next is sent downstream to the live.remote-tilde object. The right inlet of this object receives the ID so that it knows which parameter to modulate with the signal coming in the left inlet.